going to welcome you several times. Right now, we'll just make sure everyone is seated to all our... We can hear people chatting on the... I think actually can do this. We can hear people chatting on the background because they haven't seen each other in a long time, and how wonderful it is to connect and the sparkling, crispy Shabbat morning. So I just would like to say welcome, and I will re-welcome you again, but at the moment we are all here as we begin on page 141.
We start with a little nigger. And we shall now go on to page 153 for morning blessings.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu ha'olamim ha'maavir sheina meinai u'tnuma me'af apai. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu ha'olamim הנותן לשך ובינה, להבחין בין יום ובין לילה. ברוך אתה, אדוני, אלוהינו חי העולמים, רוק הארץ המים. ברוך אתה, אדוני, אלוהינו חי העולמים, פוקח עברים. ברוך אתה, אדוני, אלוהינו חי העולמים, Blessed are you, redeeming one, our God, life of all the worlds, who makes the captive free. Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu chei ha'olamim, zokef kefufim. Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu chei ha'olamim, המכין מצדי גבר. ברוך אתה, אדוני, אלוהינו חי העולמים, שעשה לי כל צורכים. ברוך אתה, אדוני, אלוהינו חי העולמים, עוזר ישראל בגבורה. ברוך אתה, אדוני, אלוהינו חי העולמים, עותר ישראל בתפארה. ברוך אתה, אדוני, אלוהינו חי העולמים, שעשני בצלמו. ברוך אתה, אדוני, אלוהינו חי העולמים, שעשני בת חורין. ברוך אתה, אדוני, אלוהינו חי העולמים, שעשני ישראל. ברוך אתה, אדוני, אלוהינו חי העולמים, הנותן ליעף כוח. ברוך אתה, אדוני, אלוהינו מלא העולם, אשר יצר את האדם בחוכמה ובראבו נקבים, נקבים, חלולים, חלולים. גלוי ידו, למות לפניך. ברוך אתה, אדוני, רופא כל בשר ומפליא לעשות.
We are on page 165. My God, the soul you gave me is pure.
Shabbat shalom.
now continue on page 209.
Mizmor shir leyom ha-shabbat, tov lehodot la-adonai, uzamer leshimcha elyon, lehagid baboker chasdecha, ve'emunatecha balelot, alei asor va'alei navel, alei higayon bechinor, Alei asor v'alei navel, alei higayon bechinor.
And we continue chanting the last four lines on page 211.
Tzadikato amor yifkach, ke'eretz bavonon yizkeh, shetulim beveit Adonai, Bechatzot Eloheinu Yafrichu Ot Yenuvun Beseva Deshenim Verananim Yiyu Lehadkik Yashar Adonai Tzuri Tzuri Velo avla tobo.
I just would like to make sure that all of us have an opportunity to stay in this with this beautiful prayer book and allow our soul to soar and the heart to be open. So if to all of our guests and those who have joined us usually here every Shabbat morning, we are saying our morning brachot from Kol HaNeshama, which is a siddur that is thoughtfully compiled with wonderful transliterations, which is the English sounded as Hebrew, so we can follow, as well as wonderful commentaries that allow us, even if we do not turn to the page that is announced, to be and to be engaged and receive sweetness of this wonderful Shabbat. So to all our guests, and of course, so many of you both here on Zoom as well as here in the sanctuary, mere people who came to celebrate with your family, Mia Angel McGrinder will become a bat mitzvah this morning, as well as we will be celebrating Lianka Lichtenberg as well. And those of you who are on Zoom and the magic of it, to be able to connect throughout North America, to be able to be present, celebratory to the family and friends and Darchei Noam, beautiful Shabbat Shalom, and stay open, present, and delighted with this exquisite moment to the parents and grandparents.
And now we continue with Psalm 121 on page 215. My help is from the unseen one, the maker of the heavens and the earth, as I lift my eyes up to the hills. From where will the help come?
Sheer lama,
35. The soul of every living thing shall bless your name, Eternal One.
Nishmat kol chai tevarech et shimcha, Adonai Eloheinu, veruach kol basar tevareu tchomem, zichrecha malkeinu tamid min haolam. Ve'ad ha'olam, ato el, ato el.
Oops. We continue, we are on page 241. I had to check my script.
Yes.
241. Nihalecha shabechacha fa'ercha nevarechet shem kodshecha ka'amur le'David barchi nafshi et Adonai ve'chol kravai et shem Ha'el b'tatzumor uzecha ha'gadol b'chvod shemecha ha'gibol enetzach v'nora v'norotecha ha'melech ha'yoshev al kisei ram v'nisa shochen ad marom v'kadosh shemo v'chatuv ranenu tzadikim b'adonai l'sharim nava tehillah B'fir shorim tit romam, u'divrei tzadikim tit barach, u'vilshon chasidim tit kadash, u'v'kerev kedoshim tit halal. U'machalot revavot amcha beit Yisrael. We continue privately. Ishtabach shimcha la'ad malkeinu ha'el ha'melech ha'gadol kasher shamayim v'aretz. Barach ha'me'ata v'yad olam baruch ata Adonai el melech gadol batishbachot el ha'odaot adon ha'niflaot ha'bocher b'shirei zimra melech el Chei ha'olamim Yitkadal v'yitkadash Shemei Rabbah V'yalmad yivrach yirutei V'yamlich malchutei V'chayechon v'yomechon U'v'chayei d'chol beit Yisrael Ba'agala v'yizman kariv V'ymeru Amen Yehe Shemei Rabbah M'vorach le'olam olalmei almaya Yitbarach v'yishtabach v'yitpa'av d'romam v'yitnasei v'yitadar v'yitale v'yitalal Shmei d'kudesha b'richu L'elam in kol birchata v'shirata Tushpechata v'nechemata T'amiran b'yalma v'imru Amen We rise for b'richu. We're on page 247.
Baruch Hu et Adonai HaMevorach Baruch Adonai HaMevorach Le'olam Va'ed Baruch Adonai HaMevorach Le'olam Va'ed Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech HaOlam Yotzer Or Vorei Choshech Ose Shalom Uvorei Et HaKol
And we are seated. We turn to page 265.
Titbarach tzureinu malkeinu v'goaleinu.
Who are holy beings? They are beloved, clear of mind, and courageous. Their will and God's are one. Raising their voices in constant gratitude, they marvel at every detail of life, granting each other loving permission to be exactly who they are. When we listen for their sweet voices, we can hear the echo within our own souls. We're at the top of page 267. Et shem ha'el ha'melech gadol ha'gibor ve'hanora kadoshu mechulam mekablim aleihem ol malchut shamayim ze mizeh ve'nodnim bi'avar reshut ze lazeh le'agdish le'tzram machat ruach b'safa v'nak nakusha kulam ki'echad onim ve'omrim bi'ira kadosh, kadosh, kadosh Adonai tzivaot meloch ol ha'aretz kevodo Theophanim v'chayot ha'kodesh b'rash gadol mitnasim l'umat serafim l'umatam meshabchim ve'omrim baruch kevod Adonai mimkomo. Last two lines on page 269. Or chadash al Zion ta'ir v'nizkechu lanu b'mehera le'oro baruch ata Adonai Yotzer Hameorot, page 273. Ahava Rabba Avtanu, Adonai Eloheinu, Chemla Dola Viteira, Hamalta Aleinu, Avinu Malkeinu, Bavur Avotenu Vimotenu, Shabbatu vecha, Shabbatu vecha, Avinu Malkeinu. Vat lamdem chukei chayim, Kein tichoneinu tlamdeinu, Kein tichoneinu utlamdeinu. Avinu havarachaman, Ham rachem, rachem aleinu, avinu, av harachaman, ham rachem, rachem aleinu, v'tein b'libeinu lechavinu lechaskil, lechavinu lechaskil, lishmoa lilmod ulelamed, lishmor v'la'asot ulekayem, Et kol divrei Talmud Toratecha be'ahava v'cha ereinu v'Toratecha v'dabek libeinu v'mitzvotecha v'yachel levavenu le'ahava u'lira et shemecha v'lo nevosh Velo nikalem, velo nikasher, leolam va'el, ki v'shem kodshecha, hagadol v'hanora batachnu, nagila v'nismicha, Nagila v'nismecha v'yeshuatecha V'yavienu shalom y'arba k'nfot ha'aretz M'kinu k'morot seinu k'e'el p'er sharata K'iftanu shimcha gadol sela b'yemet L'odot l'cha l'cha b'yava baruch ata Adonai Ohev amo Yisrael In gathering together the four corners of the talit, we gather our scattered thoughts and focus on unity, uniting our people, uniting the disparate elements of our lives, uniting with the oneness that links all that is. This inner unity is the place out of which our hearts speak the Shema. We're on page 277.
Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad.
Ve'ahavta et Adonai Elohecha v'chol levavcha u'v'chol nafshecha u'v'chol me'odecha v'hayu hadvarim ha'ele asher anochi mitzavecha hayom alevavecha v'shinantam levanecha v'dibarta bam v'shivtecha b'veitecha uvelechtecha avaderech uveshoch b'cha uvekumecha, ukshartam le'ot al yodecha, v'hayu letotafot bein einecha, uvtaftam al mezuzot beitecha, uvisharecha. We continue on page 285 privately.
And at this moment, we usually pause as we prepare for our Amidah, this formal part of Shacharit service, and it is my pleasure to ask the proud father of our Bat Mitzvah, Mark McGrinder, to come forward this morning and punctuate our service with a favorite reading.
Good morning. I'm very appreciative of the opportunity to come up here and share a little piece of writing about the power of the human voice raised in song. Anyone who knows our family, who knows Mia, knows how important singing is. In our home, when Mia was born, my mom, who's here with us today, came to visit us in the hospital, was holding her, and as she was walking around with her, Mia was making all kinds of sounds, just like, and my mom looked at me and she said, "Oh, Mark, she's gonna be a singer." And I was like, "Yep, okay, sure, Mom. Like, that diaper's pretty wet. Perhaps she'll be a urologist. I don't know." Like, but she was right. My mom was right. Mia's a singer. She loves to sing. And today, as you've seen and as she will continue to do, she'll raise her voice in song to share familiar blessings with you all. Because in most every faith, the power and potency of prayer is augmented by song. So I'd like to share this little piece of writing by Salman Rushdie. Why do we care about singers? Wherein lies the power of songs? Maybe it derives from the sheer strangeness of there being singing in the world. The note, the scale, the chord, melodies, harmonies, arrangements, symphonies, ragas, Chinese operas, jazz, the blues. That such things should exist, that we should have discovered the magical intervals and distances that yield the poor cluster of notes all within the span of a human hand from which we can build our cathedrals of sound, is as alchemical a mystery as mathematics or wine or love. Maybe the birds taught us, maybe not. Maybe we're just creatures in search of exaltation. We don't have much of it. Our lives are not what we deserve. They are, let us agree, in many painful ways, deficient. Song turns them into something else. Song shows us a world that is worthy of our yearning. It shows us ourselves as they might be if we were worthy of the world. Five mysteries hold the keys to the unseen. The act of love, and the birth of a baby, and the contemplation of great art, and being in the presence of death and disaster, and hearing the human voice lifted in song. These are the occasions when the bolts of the universe fly open and we are given a glimpse of what is hidden, an F of the ineffable. Thank you.
We continue on page 291.
Tilot lel elyon baruch hu umvorach Moshe umiriam uvenei Yisrael achanu shira besimcha rabba v'yamru kulam mi chamocha ba'elim Adonai mi chamocha nedar ba'kodesh
Nora tehilot, osefele, shirachadasha shifchu gulim, lishimcha sefat hayam, yachad kulam hodu v'imlichu ve'amaru, Adonai imloch leolam va'ed. Tzur Yisrael, kuma be'ezrat Yisrael, uvteichnu mechai Yehuda ve'Yisrael. Goaleinu Adonai tzevaot shemo, kedosh Yisrael. Baruch ata Adonai, Goal Yisrael.
As we approach the Amidah, I would remind you, it is a standing prayer, but if you are not comfortable standing, please feel free to be seated. We're on page 295.
Adonai sefatai tiftach ufi agit hilatecha. Adonai sefatai tiftach ufi agit hilatecha. Baruch ata Adonai, Eloheinu, v'Elohei avotenu v'imotenu, Elohei Avraham, Elohei Yitzchak, Elohei Yaakov, Elohei Sarah, Elohei Rivka, Elohei Rachel, v'Elohei Leah, Ha'el Hagadol, Hagibor v'Hanora, El Elyon, Gomel Chasadim Tovim, V'kone hakol, v'zocher chastei avot v'imot, u'mevi gula livnei v'nehem, leman shemo b'ahava, melech ozer u'moshia u'magen. Baruch ata Adonai, magen Avraham v'ezrat Sara. Ata gibor le'olam Adonai, rav le'hoshia. Mashiv haruach umorit hagashem, mechalkel chayim bechesed, mechayei kol chay berachamim rabim, zomech noflim virofei cholim, umatir asurim, umekayem emunato, lishenei afar. Michamocha bal gevurot umidomelach melech meimit umechaye umatzmiach Yeshua v'ne'aman atal chayot kol chay baruch ata Adonai mechaye kol chay.
Page 303.
Nikadesh et shimcha ba'olam, keshem shemakdishim oto bishmei marom, kakatuv yad nevi'echa, v'kara ze el ze ve'amar. Kadosh, 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 Adonai tzevaot, meloch kol ha'aretz kevodo. Az bekol rash gadol, adir v'chazak mashmim kol, midnasim liumat serafim, liumatam baruch yomeru, baruch kevod Adonai, mimkoma, mimkomecha malkeinu, tofia, tofia, v'timloch aleinu, Kimechakim, kimechakim anachnu lach, matai timloch, timloch b'tzion, bekaro b'yameinu, leolam va'ed tishkon, titgadal v'titgadash, betoch Yerushalayim ircha, titgadal v'titgadash, Betoch Yerushalayim ircha, ledor vador, ulenetzach netzachim, ve'einenu tirena. Malchutecha Kadavar Ha'amur B'Shirei Uzecha Imloch Adonai Le'olam Elohayich Tzion L'dor v'dor Halleluya L'dor v'dor, L'dor v'dor L'dor v'dor Nagid God Lecha Ulenetzach Netzachim Ulenetzach Netzachim Kedushat Hanakdish L'dor v'dor, L'dor v'dor L'dor v'dor Nagid God Lecha Ulenetzach Netzachim Ulenetzach Netzachim Kedushat Hanakdish Veshivchacha Eloheinu Mipinu Lo Yamush Leolam Vaed Ki El Melech Gadol Ki El Melech Gadol Vekadosh Ata L'dor v'dor, l'dor v'dor, l'dor v'dor, nagid God lecha, ulenetzach netzachim, ulenetzach netzachim, kedushat hanadish, baruch ata Adonai, ha'el ha'kadosh.
We'll continue with the Amidah and silent prayer. Reflection and meditation, and then we will be together at the top of page 319.
And at this moment, we will extend the fringes of our tallit, our embrace to those who stand next to us, friends, family, Darchei Noam community. Please make sure nobody stands alone. So we are on page 319, and those of you who are, this is always this very special moment among our guests and our family when we, and friends, when we reintroduce ourselves, the magic of touch, when our shoulders relax and we feel a closeness to the individual, whether we know them well or not, or we're getting to know them. And to those of you who are on Zoom, dear family, friends, you might be in the sanctuary of your own homes, in the safety of your home, our heart and our soul connected to through the bonds of Darchei Noam. We're on page 319 as we recite Birchat HaShalom.
Eloheinu ve'elohei avoteinu v'imoteinu, Baruchenu b'Avraham Shuleshet Hamur, Hamura mipi Aharon uvanav ka'amur. Yevarechecha Adonai v'yishmerecha, ken yehi ratzon, ya'er Adonai panav elecha, v'ichunecha, ken yehi ratzon, yisa Adonai panav elecha,
V'yasem lecha shalom, ken yehi ratzon. Sim shalom tova uvracha, chen vachesed verachamim. Aleinu ve'al kol Yisrael, amecha. Barachenu avinu, kulanu ke'echad, ve'or panecha, sim shalom, ki ve'or panecha, natata lanu Adonai Eloheinu, Torat Chaim, V'ahavat Chesed, Tzedaka uveracha. Verachamim v'chaim, v'chaim v'shalom, v'tov be'enecha levarech, et amcha Yisrael, v'et kol hamim Shalom, sim shalom, tova uvracha, chen vachesed verachamim, aleinu ve'al kol Yisrael, amecha. Baruch ata Adonai, oseh ha-shalom.
Page 381. Yikada vikada shame rabba, Bealma divrachirutev, Yamlich Malchute, Bahayehon, Yehon, Hayeho, Beit Yisrael, Bagala, Rizman, Karive, Imeru, Amen, Yeheshme, Rabba, Mevorach, Leolamu, Alme, Almaya, Yitbarach, Yitbarach, Vishtabach, Vipoav, Roman, Vitnase, Vitadar, Vitale, Vitalal, Shmedi Kudisha, Brichule, Ela, Minkol, Birchata, Vishirata, Tushbechata, Venechamata, Amiran, Bialmave, Imeru, Amen, Titkabel, Zethonavichon, Dechobet Israel, Kadamavichon, Shemaya, Imeru, Yehesh, Lama Rabba, Min Shemaya, Vechayim, Elenu, Vialkol, Israel, Imeru,
Amen.
Ose shalom bimromav hu yase shalom aleinu v'al kol Yisrael v'al kol yoshvei tevel ve'imeru amen. And we are seated.
Again, welcome, and such a wonderful atmosphere in the sanctuary. So much to celebrate, to learn, to acknowledge, and to all of your warmest regards. And we are about to approach our Torah service, so it is my pleasure to ask our Parnasid this morning, Rabbi Gitterman, to come forward for this Shabbat HaChodesh, this special Shabbat that will be leading us very, very soon towards our Seder table. So, welcome.
Shabbat shalom, everyone, people at home, people in the sanctuary, guests, everyone, welcome. If you do not have one already, this is the time, as we always announce, to get a chumash from the side wall. And the page numbers for today's reading are on the printed sheets that you have. If you have an aliyah this morning, a reminder that you should go to the podium on your far left, my right. And reading Torah this morning will be Rob Silver. And our Torah service will be conducted by Lenka. And our two Torah carriers this morning will be Joel Greenberg and Minda Davis.
So we are on page 383.
Ein kamocha v'Elohim Adonai ve'ein kema'asecha Mahutecha mahut kol olamim u'memshotecha bechol dor v'dor Adonai melech Adonai malach Adonai imloch le'olam va'en Adonai oz le'amo yitein Adonai yevarech et shamo v'shalom Ava Vayhi bin so Aaron bayomer Moshe kuma Adonai veyafutzu vecha veyanusu mesanecha mipanecha ki mitzion tetzei Torah
Page 387. Tiftach libi be'oraito V'tashlim mishalin de'libi V'libad echol amach Yisrael Tafu lechayin ve'lishlam Echad Eloheinu Gadol
You may be seated.
There was this lovely slight adjustment, the fact that we usually do processional, you know, starting in one corner and another. There is really quite a bit of flexibility in reconstruction circles. When do we go? And if we're not clear, we're going to create a subcommittee that can help to wrestle this out at Kiddush, so I need a chair for that.
And we will. So
this is what you call to all our guests and those of you who smile on Zoom, and I can tell you are through this, you know, sort of prism and vision. We are part of this marvelously vocal and multidimensional, fun, thoughtful, deep thinkers and passionate community. And we thrive as a result of people who come forward and make these extraordinary efforts, both young and of all ages, and to say, this is my place. This is my place, and I will stand as the member of this community after learning and preparing and take on a mantle of leadership, a place of being an adult Jew. No doubt that it's very helpful if the parents and grandparents are supportive from all walks of life, but it's also extraordinary when it is a young person who steps forward and says, I want to do this. And without that partnership, the day wouldn't be possible, and the sparks that fly from that experience to all of us and live in our hearts and sustain us for weeks and maybe even years to come wouldn't have been as bright and as present. So it is my absolute pleasure, Mia, to ask you to come forward. And this morning, a presentation of your talit, this very special place of a mitzvah, of this four-corner garment with tzitzit that marks you as an adult Jew in our community, will be presented to you by your grandparents. So I'm going to ask Joel and Phyllis to come forward with you, Mia, and then Mir, you are going to deliver your words of Torah to share with us.
Mia, in a moment, Safta is going to give you your talit, which was your great-grandmother's talit, Safta's mother's talit, and she will explain to you how it has come down to you. And it is going to be the garment that you will wear whenever you choose to wear it. And by putting it on, you will see, and anybody who knows you will see, that you are carrying the history of that family with you. And that's on the outside. And inside, you have your Hebrew names, Shifra and Tova. And Shifra is named for Sybil, Cousin Arlene's mother, the woman who, with Safda, were much more like mother and daughter than cousins. And Tova is named for my mother. And my mother was the Safda that your mother and Tia grew up with and knew so well. And both of these women were gentle, kind, loving, and I think foremost for both of them, even though they didn't know each other, was their capacity to welcome people completely free of judgment, completely open to whoever people were. And I can see how, without even having had this discussion with you before, you've already absorbed the truth of who those women are in the woman you have become. So let their names be a blessing for you and a guiding light in your life.
Mia, this tallit belonged, as Papa said, to your great-grandmother, Bubby Rhoda. She wore it with pride and humility, and she felt comforted and embraced by the fabric and the tradition, somewhat ahead of her time as a Jewish woman. May this moment of your affirmation of your Jewish identity always remind you who you are, the community to which you belong, and the spiritual tradition that is yours. May you continue to grow each day in concern for those in need. May you grow each day in wisdom and compassion. And may the source of blessing known to our ancestors continue to be present in your life. And here our community all says, Amen.
Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Asher Kitchanu B'mitzvotav V'tzivanu Lahitatev Batziti. Shabbat Shalom. My name's Mia, and I turned 13 just 2 weeks ago. Before the pandemic, I used to come here to Darchei Noam every week with my safta and sister, and I would watch people having their b'nai mitzvah and hope for that to be me someday. But since I don't read or speak Hebrew, I wanted to do this in a way that made sense for me. My mom told me all the different things I could do, and I decided to do a b'nai mitzvah program with an organization called Shoresh. This program is called Yesod, and it is a coming-of-age journey that doesn't require any previous Jewish knowledge, and it welcomes all types of Jews. In Yesod, we learn about Judaism through nature. I also wanted to have an aliyah and sing with my safta because it makes me feel part of the Jewish community and the community of Darchei Noam. Because of COVID, I wasn't able to come to shul for a long time, and I have missed the tradition of going every week, having Kiddush, and seeing other kids and people like Lana and Saul and the other teenagers who ran the children's program. Today, I feel like I'm reconnecting to the community. A new community I've joined this year is Yesod, which I have been doing since September. We meet twice every month, once on a Wednesday evening and one full day on Sunday. The first Wednesday of Yesod was in my new friend Eitan's Bubby's backyard. This was an introduction circle where everyone met each other, learned about the program, and were blessed by our parents. On the first Sunday, we went to Bela Farm, a farm just outside of Toronto. There, we learned about the program, setting goals for ourselves, facing challenges, and confronting or apologizing to people for things we have done, told or untold, which are things that we are ashamed of or feel sorry for. This was around the time of Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur. We have also made lots of cool projects at Yesod. The most recent week, we did basket weaving using different widths of dogwood and partners. On other weeks, we have done things like making candles out of beeswax for Hanukkah, weaving mats out of cattail plants for our own use outside in nature, printing using black walnut ink on white birch bark to learn about scribing, and more. All of these skills we've been learning are helping us get ideas for the ritual objects we will be making at the end of the year. In addition to that, we have learned about different Jewish holidays throughout the year, their stories, and things we can do to celebrate them. One of the Sundays, we spent learning about Tu B'Shvat, which inspired me to create a Tu B'Shvat Seder for my family. We learned about what the four different fruits represent: mind, motion, physical body, and soul, and enjoyed them with our meal. And with my cousins on Zoom, we talked about our observations of the plants and trees around us. There are a couple of events this program leads to at the end of the year, including the end of year camping trip, the graduation ceremony, and our ritual object making. For my ritual object, I'll be making a Haggadah cover, which I'm currently in the planning stages of, but will be starting to make soon. I think it is very appropriate that the Torah portion today is about ritual items, because that is a big part of what I'm doing this year. I'm looking forward to completing my Haggadah cover that will hopefully be passed down in my family for a while and will get a lot of good use and care put into it. I will be making a Haggadah cover for a couple reasons. One, because Pesach has always been one of my favorite Jewish holidays. Two, it's because during our seders with family and friends, my mom will often make her own Haggadah in a way. Meaning, she will take pieces of writing intended for Passover seders created by different people and put them together to host a Passover seder. This has been a tradition for several years and I hope to continue it, and I think making a Haggadah cover to hold the pages is a great way to encourage that. I have been wanting to have my first Aliyah for a long time. I have been learning about Judaism this past year, and I will be learning more about it in the months to come. I will also be discovering what my Judaism means to me, and of course this is different for everyone. I'm very happy to be participating in this Jewish coming-of-age tradition because it connects me to my culture. I am very honored to be able to become a bat mitzvah here when COVID has calmed down a little bit. Thank you, Rabbi Tina, for welcoming me and my family and supporting us. I feel really grateful that my family is able to come here, including my dad's side of the family, my grandma, my uncle, and aunts and cousins. Thank you to my Safta, who helped me a lot. She called me every day to work on my blessings and taught me a lot about the meaning of a bat mitzvah. My parents and my papa also helped, but I would especially like to thank my Safta for being so supportive. She always puts so much care into Darhei Noam and into loving her family and friends. And without her, this speech would be very grammatically incorrect. Thank you. Shabbat Shalom.
This is sweet, truly beautifully sweet and thoughtful and well-prepared and authentic and real. Thank you. What a lovely, lovely moment and marking of family heritage connections, multidimensional way of we exist in the world, and deep, deep affection for our children and our history and humanity. So I think this is, a terrific opening to reading our Torah. So we're going to continue, and there will be more singing and moments of celebration.
So to continue with our celebrations in the Torah service this morning, it is my honor to call Lenka Lichtenberg And if you have not already heard, let me be the one to say that Lenka won a Juno Award recently for her album Thieves of Dreams in honor of her grandmother's poems written in the Theresienstadt concentration camp during the Holocaust. Vea zor via gain via shiach l'chol chasim bo v'namar amen. Akol havo godel Eloheinu utnu chavad la'torah nala amod migdala bat Bratislav hart v'yana rene friesova l'aliyah harishona baruch anatan Torah le'amo Yisroel b'kdushato
ve'atam avikim banana lo'achem chaim kuchem ayom. Our reading, we are of course reading traditionally double parshiot via Kalk Pikudei. We are coming towards the end of the book of Shemot. I'll give you a little bit more instruction about that shortly. We are beginning our reading this morning from Parshat Vayakel, and we begin our reading in Exodus Shemot chapter 38 with verse 1.
Bahu et anonai hamvoha.
Baruch anonai varach elam voed.
Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melei haolam. Asher kervanu l'avodato venatan lanu et torato. Baruch ata Adonai noten haTorah.
Amen. Vayas et mizbach alatz eshitim chamesh amot arko vechamesh amot rachbod ravua veshalosh amot komato Vayos karnotov, nahal arba penotav, mimenu ayu karnotav, vayetzav oto nechoshet. Vayos ekokle hamizbeuch, et asirot verayahim ramizrakot, ורמיז לקו ורמחתות, קוקלו וסנחושת, ויחס למזבח מכפר, מסרסת נחושת, תוחת ככופו. מלמטו,
Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melei haolam Asher natan lanu Torat emet V'chayei olam nata betocheinu Baruch ata Adonai Noten haTorah.
So I just would like to say a few words to my dear colleague and a friend and a partner in the sacred rites of Darchei Noam, to describe our absolute elation to be made aware of this extraordinary honor is both profoundly moving, and I speak on behalf, I think, of all of us here on Zoom and the Jewish community. I would like to say that every high holiday service, every other Shabbat, if not every Shabbat, through mask or with no mask,
you have granted our community with your talent, with such extraordinary generosity and care and a deep, deep concern for Jewish life and the Jewish future. Your award, your life's work, gave voice to men and women and children who perished. You lost 6 million. We lost 6 million. But with your voice and your art, you gave them voices and a song. I think it is Abraham Joshua Heschel, and if I misquoted, please correct me, just not during the service, who said there are three ways to attend to your sorrow. One is to cry. One is to be silent. And one is to make your sorrow into a song. Your mother and your grandmother, your family, and the church Jewish community is singing through you. You sing from your profound love of life and triumph over destruction. May the Holy One continue to inspire you, and may you always find support and love in our community. You are loved and deeply appreciated. May your talent soar.
Simintov, Mazeltov, Mazeltov, Simintov, Simintov, Mazeltov, Mazeltov, Simintov, Simintov, Mazeltov, Mazeltov, Simintov, Yehelano, 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 Olecho Israel, Yehelano, Yehelano, Olecho Israel.
I just want to put in a plug for the program on April 30th.
Please.
That Lenka is presenting Thieves of Dreams here at the Sunday. I'm not sure of the time, but it's probably, I don't know, 7:30. So we should all come.
And please, our warmest Reuben to you and to Rachel, Hannah, and Benjamin, who are often here and with love and appreciation.
And Hannah. Yes. So carrying on with our celebrations, for the second Aliyah, we are calling the parents of our Darshan, of our birthday girl, Mia. We are calling Jessica Greenberg and Mark McGrinder. Nadla Amod, Yiska Malach Batzipora VeYakov, Lalia Hashniya.
And our reading is continuing Exodus, Book of Shmot, chapter 38, with verse
5. Baruch Adonai Hamvorach Le'olam Va'ed. Baruch Atah Adonai. Eloheinu melech haolam, asher kervanu lavodato, v'natan lanu et torato, baruch ata Adonai noten haTorah.
Amen. Amen. Vayitzok arba tabahot. Biar baksavot lemichbaran choshet batim labadim vayased abadim atzei shitim vayetzavotam nechoshet vayaved abadim batabahot nahatzalot amizbeach laset oto bahem Nevuf lechot nasoto.
Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam Asher natan lanu Torat emet V'chaye olam nata b'tochenu Baruch ata Adonai notein haTorah.
Please rise as we offer a mishaberach for those in need of healing. For the third Aliyah this morning, we are calling our Darshan, Mia. Nala Amod, Shifra Tova Bat Yiska Vemark, Lalia Hashlishit.
And our reading continues, Shemot, Exodus chapter 38, beginning with verse 8.
Vinatan lanu et torato, Baruch ata Adonai, notein haTorah.
Amen. And I'm just reminding myself that I have a little reminder for all of you as well. Now, we are technically reading Parshat Vayakhel, but it is a composite part of a double Parshiot, Vayakhel Pekudei, which terminates or ends the reading of the book of Shemot. As we read the last words of a book of Torah in this community, notwithstanding the fact that this doesn't happen to be the maftir of Pekudei, which would normally be the last words, simply because this is Shabbat HaChodesh, you'll note that we have a second Torah. We'll be reading a much lengthier maftir momentarily from that second scroll. We need to acknowledge the end of the passage of the book of Shemot. These will be the final words recited this year. And what I'm going to ask you to do, this is a three-verse reading. The beginning of the third verse, I will simply ask you to rise. At the termination of that third verse, we all collectively will recite the words Chazak Chazak, Venit Chazek, from strength to strength, and we will strengthen. beginning chapter 38, verse 8.
Amen. Vayaset akion echoshet vet kanon echoshet bemarodatsovo hodasher tsavu betachohemohet vayaset echatser lifot negev temano Kalehatzer shesh masahar me'abamahot.
Please rise.
Amudehem esrim v'adnehem esrim nechoshet v'amudim V'chashokehem kosuf chazak v'nirchazek.
Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Asher Natan Lanu Torah Demet V'chayei Olam Nita Betochenu Baruch Ata Adonai Noten HaTorah.
And we will, you may be seated. My apologies. We, of course, at this moment in time, extend a special Mishra Berach to Mia, which says, may the one who blessed our ancestors, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, Sarah, Rebecca, Rachel, and Leah, bless Mia Angel McGrinder, who has come forward this day to the blessing of the Torah in recognition of her desire to live a worthy Jewish life. And may she continue to grow in body and in spirit, in wisdom and humility, in the love of all creatures, in faithfulness and courage. And may she be regarded as gracious and wise in the eyes of God and all of humanity. And to this, let us all say,
Amen.
V'imotenu Sarah Rivka Rachav Leah, uyivarechet shifra tova, bat yiska, v'mag, abchura bat mitzvah, ashalata larishana latorah, korosh baruch hu yishmereha v'etzileha mikol tzara v'tzuka, v'yasem libav tov yira tov l'asor tzoro, ulavdo b'navav shalem kol hayamim, V'nomar Amen. Simen tavu, mazel tavu, mazel tavu, simen tavu, simen tavu, mazel tavu, mazel tavu, simen tavu, simen tavu, mazel tavu, mazel tavu, simen tavu. Ve'elahanu, ve'elam ve'elahanu.
Now, usually at this exquisite moment, we have our children to just run up and pick up the beautiful little treat. I can see that there's someone in the background. We would love for you to come up, and then there's somebody else also who has not had their bat mitzvah, also is welcome to come up. We've gathered them in a basket, so please do not be shy. You will have another opportunity when we bless you near the Ark before as we put Torah away. Okay. So you'll have a double portion, no problem. Okay.
And we continue with Chatzi Kaddish. Yitgadal v'yitgadash, Sheme Rabo.
Amen.
Yalma divrei chiruti, v'yamlich malchutei becha yechon uv'yom echon, uv'chaye dechol beit Yisrael, v'agala v'zman kariv v'yemeru.
Amen.
Yishme Rabo mevorach, le'alo le'omeo maya, Yitbarach, Yitbarach, Vishtabach, Vitboar, Vitromam, Vitnasei, Vitadar, Vitale, Vitalal, Sheme de Kudisha, Berihu, Leila, Minkol Birchata, Vishirata, Tushbechata, Venechemata, Dami, Ran Bealama. V'yemeru, amen. And at this time, I will ask you to rise as we call our first Hagbah and Galila, Joel Troster and Barbara Miller.
וזאת התורת עץ חיים היא למחזיקים ותומכיה מאושר.
So you may recall that last week we read Shabbat, it was Shabbat Para, we read a special maftir from Parshat Chukat. I did note that it happened to be the very longest maftir reading of the year. Well, this week's is Shabbat HaChodesh, special maftir in reference to the events that precede the crossing of the Sea of Reeds, the release of the Israelites from the bondage of the Egyptians. Nestle in, because this is a very close second for length. But I also will note, and I note his presence here today, this happens to be the maftir reading of my former bar mitzvah student, David Shizgal, the son of Rabbi Tina, who is here today, and 5 years later, now you know how old he is, and I said to him, I'm going to try to do you proud. So we are continuing our reading. We are turning back a little bit in our text. We remain in the book of Shemot, chapter 12, verse 1.
And for our maftir aliyah, we are calling Meir Bester. Nala amod, Meir ben Freda v'Shimon, la maftir.
Baruch et Adonai Hamvorach.
Baruch Adonai Hamvorach Leolam Vaed.
Baruch Adonai Hamvorach Leolam Vaed. Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam, Asher Kervanu Laavodato Venatan Lanu Et Torato. Baruch Ata Adonai Noten HaTorah.
Amen. Amen. Vayomer Adonai Moshe v'el Aaron be'eretz Mitzrayim lemor Chodesh hazeh lachem rosh chodashim rishon hu lachem lechadshei hashanah Dabro el kol atahad Yisroel lemor be'asor lachodesh hazeh v'ikhu lachem yish sehel v'davot sel habayit v'mimimata bayit miyad misev lakachu ushcheno hakarov beito b'michsa nefashot ish lefi achlot achosu halaseh Zetamim, Zachar ben Shana, Yiyu lachem, Yiyeh lachem, Min akvasim, min aizim, tikachu. Ve'ayah lachem, lemishmeret, Ot arbasar, Yom lachor shazeh, v'shechatu ato. Kohol kehaladad Yisroel ben arbaim velakhu min adam venadnu al shtem zuzoh ve'al mashkod al abadim ashe yachlu oto bahem ויאכלו את הבשר בלילה הזה, אצלי רש מצות אמרורים יאכלו, אל תאכלו ממנו נע, ובשם ובושה במים, כי אם סלי רש ראשו אל קרב. אש ראש הקרב ועל קיבוב לא תותיר ממנו עד בוקר והנותר ממנו עד בוקר באש תשרפו וככה תאכלו אותו מדניכם חגורים נעליכם רגליכם מכיכם בידכם וחרתם אותו בחיפזון, פסח ולרונוי. ועברתי בארץ מצרים, בלילה הזה. ויכיתי כה בכה בארץ מצרים, מאדם ועד בהמה, ובכל אלוהי מצרים. עשר שבטים אני ארוני, והיה אדם לכם להיות על הבתים אשר את אותם שם ראיתי את אדם ופסחתי עליכם ולא יהיה בכם נגף למשחית ביקותי ביקותי בארץ מצרים והיה היום הזה לכם לסיכרון וחגותם אותו חג לאדוני לדורותיכם חוקת עולם תחכו שבעת ימים מצות אכלו ביום הראשון תשפיטו שיער מבתיכם כי כל אוכל חמץ ונכרתה הנפש ההיא מישראל מיום הראשון עד יום השביעי וביום הראשון מקרא קודש וביום השביעי מקרא קודש יהיה לכם כל מלאכה לא יעשה בכם אשר יאכל כל נפש הוא לבדו יעשה לכם ושמעתם את המצות כי בעצם היום הזה הוצאתי צפותיכם מארץ מצרים ושמעתם את היום הזה לדורותיכם חוקת עולם בראשון בבוא Sora Hayom La Hodish Barreth, Doch Lumatsora Hod Yom Hod Vesrim La Hodish Barreth. Shivat yamim sehor lo imatzeh bevatechem ki kol ochel machmetzet v'nichreta na nefeshahi miadad Yisroel bager v'zrachaharet ko machmetzet lo tochelu בְּחָל מַשְׁפוֹתֶיכֶם תֹּאֲכְלוּ מַצּוֹת.
ברוך אתה אדוני אלוהינו מלך העולם אשר נתן לנו תורת אמת וחיי עולם נטע בתוכנו. Baruch ata Adonai noten haTorah.
Yeshua Koach, Rob. Can I get you a glass of water?
Good.
For our second Hagbah and Galila this morning, we are calling Lawrence Reiber and Kathy Sikora. Please rise.
וזאת התורה, את חיים אילמך חזיקים בה.
ותאומר
שער. די 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 די
So we're just about to recite our Haftarah, and the setting is Ezekiel and Prophet Ezekiel, who lived in the days before and after the destruction of the first temple and preached in the early part of the 6th century before Common Era. He was exiled to Babylon, and like the second Isaiah after him, foresaw the day when the captives would be restored to their homeland. And the prophet's message gave our traditional interpreters great difficulty, but due to the like number of details. But his tremendous concern, Ezekiel, is that once people will return to their land, they will able to recreate and rebuild the temple and then adhere to the sacrificial service, and it should be done with great attention to detail as well as purity of their emotions and their deeds. So Mayor, thank you for bringing us the words of Ezekiel from 6th century before Common Era.
Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher bachar binvim tovim veratza v'divrehem hanemarim be'emet. Baruch ata Adonai habocher b'torah ובמשה עבדו, ובנביאי האמת וצדק. כל העם הארץ יהיו אל התרומה הזאת לנשיא בישראל. ועל הנשיא יהיה העולות והמנחה והנר. פסח, בחגים ובחודשים ובשבתות, בכל מועדי בית ישראל, הוא יעשה את החטאת ואת המנחה ואת העולה ואת השלמים לכפר בעד בני ישראל. כה אמר אדוני אלוהים, בראשון באחד לחודש תיקח פר בן בקר תמים וחיטאת את המקדש. ולקח הכהן מדם החטאת ונתן אל מזוזת הבית ואל ארבע פינות העזרה למזבח ועל מזוזת שער החצר הפנימית. וכן תעשה בשבעה וחודש מאיש שוגה ומפתי, וכיפרתם את הבית בראשון בארבעה עשר יום לחודש, יהיה לכם הפסח חג, שבועות ימים מצות יאכל. ועשה הנשיא ביום ההוא בעדו ובעד כל עם הארץ פר חטאת. ושבעת ימי החג יעשה עולה לאדוני שבעת פרים ושבעת אלים תמימים ליום שבעת הימים וחטאת שעיר עזים ליום, ומנחה איפה לפר ואיפה ליל יעשה, ושמן הן לאיפה. בשביעי בחמישה עשר יום לחודש בחג יעשה חיילה שבעת הימים כחטאת כעולה וכמנחה וכשמן. ברוך אתה אדוני אלוהינו מלך העולם, צור כל העולמים, צדיק בכל הדורות, האל הנאמן, האומר ועושה, המדבר ומקיים, שכל דבריו אמת וצדק. נאמן אתה הוא אדוני אלוהינו, ונאמנים דבריך. ודבר אחד מדבריך אחור לא ישוב ריקם, כי אל מלך נאמן ורחמן אתה, ברוך אתה אדוני. האל הנאמן בכל דבריו, רחם על ציון כי היא בית חיינו, ולעמך ישראל תושיע במהרה בימינו, ברוך אתה אדוני. משמח ציון באבניה,
אמן.
Samchenu Adonai Eloheinu Be'eliyahu Anavi Avdecha B'mehera Yavo Ve'yagel Libeinu Ve'yishiv Lev Avot Al Banim Ve'lev Banim Al Avotam U'veitcha Be'tfila Yikare Lechol Amim Baruch Ata Adonai Mevi Shalom La'ad על התורה ועל העבודה ועל הנביאים ועל יום השבת הזה שנתת לנו אדוני אלוהינו לקדושה ולמנוחה לכבוד ולתפארת על הכל אדוני אלוהינו אנחנו מודים לך ומברכים אותך יתברך שמך בפי כל חי תמיד לעולם ועד ברוך אתה אדוני מקדש השבת
Yeshar Koh. So beautifully and clearly chanted. It's lovely. Really beautiful mitzvah. I'm just looking at the snow. I'm not a weather person, a weather woman, you know, sort of gives you an update. But it's harder to see the snow falling on this side because you kind of see the sky. But if you turn around, you will see this absolute generous outpouring from God's pocket of these, of these snowflakes. And I'm just thinking, Mia, of your family who spend an hour and a half in the car in a good weather trying to make sure they're here for your simcha. And we're going to keep them here warm and long and sweet till this will clear and you will able to, after celebration, to make it home. So, Mir, I love when you chant with your, native Hebrew speaker and the confidence of spending years educating B'nai Mitzvah students who are now adult men and women in the Jewish community and worldwide. So much of the Haftarah, this later on prophet's writing, describes what they were hoping to see. And that is in their understanding, and an understanding of ancient people is the place to come and to gather and to say their prayers. And for ancient Israelites, meaning early Jewish people, and for their contemporaries throughout, sacrificial cult was one of the practices. It takes us a long time to evolve from it, but that is the presence. And but place where it takes this, where that happens is very important, and it's aesthetically has to be beautiful. And of course, when you look at places of worship, no matter where you are, whether you are a Jew or not, anywhere you travel, they're usually beautifully decorated, or they de-decorate it, meaning to bring them to the absolute kind of a sense of austerity and clear form, where the spirit can soar. But anywhere around this chiddush mitzvah, this elevation of the mitzvah of making a beautiful object. And so when early Mishkan in the ancient, for ancient Israelites who trapped through the desert, being slaves in the past, have an opportunity to create a place of worship of their own that is portable. I mean, just imagine, it is this par excellence IKEA project that you have to really follow directions, which is, of course, I would be not invited to participate, but unbelievable ability to create this portable, exquisite structure with things that are precious and of value that they can later on then fold and move on to another station. So we're caught in this, in a moment in our cycle of reading, is this is exactly, there's very little narrative, but it's a great attention to detail. And what is so wonderful is that I think every rabbi quoted this, or anyone who ever tried to do fundraising, it quoted this verse. Why? Because in order to create this really beautiful space, you need donations. You need people who would contribute to it. And so what do we read? Kol ish ve'isha asher nadav libam otam lechavi lakol.
Hamlacha Asher Tziva Adonai. So all those Israelites, these early Jewish people, all the men and women whose hearts moved them to bring anything for the work of God through Moses has commanded to be done, brought their free will offering. They did it, and they did it in with such generosity. They just brought their offering, their gifts, right? And so everyone brought whatever it is they had. Some had precious stones, probably lined in their pocket somewhere, you know, sewn in their capote. But they brought whatever they could, and they brought whatever jewelries they had. And then there is a group of women who bring mirrors. It's an exquisite detail that is often overlooked. They have little mirrors. Now, real mirror, as we know, mirror, kind of silver reflection, doesn't come into play much, much later in the human history. But what we did use, used brass, very, very well-polished, small piece of brass that would show you reflection. And what the copper would have been, what the brass would have been used for in this case, were create this kind of a basin where priests would wash, these ancient priests would wash and prepare themselves for the sacred ritual. And so women gather, and they bring these little mirrors. So this is what Torah tells us. And then it drops the story, right? It kind of moves on to something else. And of course, our commentators do not let this go. And so there is a beautiful oral tradition where Moses says, oh my God, what did you bring me? You brought us mirrors? Not good. Take them away. This is terrible. Why? Because mirror it reflects who you are, and it's used for purposes of beautification. This is what women brought the mirrors for. And it says this is absolutely inappropriate to build something holy for something for the Holy One. Take them away. Take these mirrors away. And following Midrash is its oral tradition. It is what's not written in a scroll, but has been brought over centuries, these extraordinary stories that fill in the text. And at this point, Midrash tells us that God speaks up and says, wait a minute, these are my actually favorite items. Don't you dare touch them. They're my favorite items. They're more dear to me than any other gifts that was brought to the temple, to this Mishkan, to this building. Because he says, don't you remember that when we were in Egypt and we were murdered and suffered slavery and we were in the fields, we decided that there should be no more children born to the families, because they would become slaves, and there should not be. So there will be the end of the Jewish people. Men decided there'll be no more families. They said no more. He says, but it were women who brought their little mirrors out into the field, polished them. Now I'm into a field of Netflix, lady, that we have some younger participants, so forgive me, nothing out of this is you haven't seen before, but they would, or heard, they would look into the mirror, great, Rashi quotes this midrash, they would look into the mirror with their husbands in the field, they would bring them some purva, and they would say, I'm more beautiful than you are. No, they would fight, I'm more beautiful than you are. And the game would be this play, this flirtatious play, that later on produce a child. You think to myself, why would anyone think of this, right? Like, it's amazing. I always want to get into the mind of people who are writing this down. Like, what were you drinking, thinking? Where were you at that time, right? But there is absolutely exquisite truth to this, is the fact when life hurts, to think of future, to think of future generation, to take upon more suffering, you don't want it. And this is what the Holy One rewards here. He says, no. The suffering eventually will end, and you will be unto another generation, but we need people. And these were great women who actually, because of them, because of that, those women, we were actually redeemed from the land of Egypt, from the slavery. And I'm not sure, Mia, if on your Seder table there is a Miriam's cup, right? There is an Ignite, and it's a modern, it's no more than about 40 years old, where we actually put, there's an Elijah cup, and we have Miriam's cup, because Miriam, the prophetess, when she walked through the wilderness, a life well of water would follow her, and we acknowledge that. And the matter of fact, this idea of the basin and the water and women has it right that respectful place at my Seder table, and so many of yours as well, is the Miriam's cup. So when it comes to mirrors, I don't think we have to make friends with it as we go throughout life, right? And I'm imagining these enthusiastic women of all ages making their way towards the construction site of the early Mishkan in the wilderness, unwrapping their small treasures, their little mirrors. What else did they have, right? Those who did not have jewelry to give, right? Or anything else. They unwrap their treasures, wiping it with a scarf and glancing it for the last time before they give away what was so precious to them. When we look into the mirror, we never see only ourselves. Our reflections are often representation of time past, experiences gathered, as well as a reminder where we came from. Our parents and grandparents look back at us from the image of the mirror. We see them in the outline of our chin, weight of our eyelids, our hairline. Mirror reflects what had been. Mia, when you look in the mirror, our foremothers, Sarah, Rebecca, Rachel, Leah, Miriam, Batya, Shifra, Pua, Deborah, Ruth, and many more, strong, determined, complicated, kind, brave. Women with prophecies look back at you. You watch them, and they watch you. Mirror reflects what is missing. In your wonderful program, Yesod, you, Mia, have learned a lot about Judaism and Jewish life, but our environment and our deep Jewish and human concern for our nature, for our earth. You created some deep friendships, and that's invaluable in life. However, something would have been amiss in the reflection of your mirror if this morning did not happen, and you would not have been sitting here in the first row with your family. It was you who initiated this rites of passage. You wanted to become bat mitzvah here at Darchei Noam, a place where your Savta Phyllis spent nearly 50 years loving, caring, and growing this community. And your stellar devoted papa, your grandfather Mark, would endure at least 50 high holiday services sitting in the front row with smile and great compose. When your parents, Mark and Jessica, received their wedding blessing, it was here at Darchei Noam, where you and your sister, as young children, played and learned, listening to your Safter's voice quenching our thirst for prayer. You decided to change what was reflected and added your wonderful image to your recent ancestors. They look back at you from Congregation Darshei Emet, Montreal, somewhere in the 1950s. There, your great-grandmother Rhoda, who spent 40 years serving as a parnas, and her mother Sophie, and then your Savta Phyllis contributed to the enhancement and development of the Reconstructionist Jewish community of Montreal. Mia, because of them, we are here. Because of your family and because of you, Mia, you are fifth generation Reconstructionist Jew. And this is pretty special. Congregation Darchei Noam, we just made history. I would like to acknowledge Rebecca, Aram, Tova, Vida, your aunt, your great aunt Sorrel, Rabbi Richard Hirsch, who was at your mother's bat mitzvah, your mother's oldest, dearest friend, Rabbi Joy Levitt. These people are on Zoom. To your dear family from Waterloo who drove to see you and to be part of this celebration. To our Darchei Noam community who watched you grow up. To your papa, to your safta, to your parents, your sister, aunts and uncles and friends. And to all of you, people of Congregation Darchei Noam, you created a place we are proud to call home. May you grow mere from strength to strength. I remember first time we met, you had these unbelievable, beautiful bangs that were so sweet and lovely. And you, and these were one of the, and then you and your, I'm off the script, so it's dangerous, but I will try to control this. There's so many words, memories, experiences of this, but it's about you and you and your sister holding hands here, sitting right over here, very gently having your little snacks and going in and out of a playroom. And then you would miss your safta and you would come up and I would see your little back. And I remember your safta's hand gently, gently she would be chanting, touching your head. And here we are this morning, and you're standing, a grown Jewish woman, choice of your own, with the extraordinary support from your father and your mother, who gave you wings to dream big. Beautiful roots in your family. We're so proud. Shabbat Shalom. We're going to recite blessing for Israel, and then we're going to do Birchat HaChodesh. Right, so we're going to ask you all to rise, please.
Please rise. Tzur Yisrael v'goalo, protector and redeemer of Israel, bless the state of Israel and all her inhabitants with the courage and strength to pursue peace and equality. Shielded beneath the wings of your love, send your light and wisdom to Israel's leaders and judges, and to those who elect and appoint them, guiding them with your good counsel and aligning them with your spirit of justice and kindness. Grant peace in the land and in the region, fulfillment of her people's hopes and joy for all who dwell there. V'simchat olam liyoshvea v'nomar. Amen. And receive with compassion our prayer on behalf of our country and its government. Bless the rich tapestry of Canada, that we may know the blessings of unity and inclusion. May we strive for true reconciliation and justice for all people. May our country be an influence for good within the family of all nations, helping to bring peace, justice, and freedom, and an end to strife for all. And bless this congregation as we discover the love of Torah, devotion in prayer, the rewards of tzedakah, the joy of community, and the gift of diversity. Bless all who enter this place and this space of worship, that the covenant here may be worthy of the greatness and love that is godliness, and that all who seek your presence here may find it. And let us say, Amen. Please remain standing as we offer a blessing for the new month.
Yes, please. So we're on page 425. If you go to the grocery store, matzah is everywhere, so you know that the month of Nisan is upon us. Yehi ratzon melfanecha, Adonai Eloheinu, Elohei avoteinu ve'imoteinu, shetechadesh aleinu et chachodesh hazeh latova ulevracha, v'titen lanu chayim arukim, chayim shel shalom. and Chaim Shel Bracha. Rosh Chodesh Nisan Yihye Bayom Hamishi Haba Aleinu Ve'al Kol Yisrael LaTova and LaShalom VeNaomar LaSason LaSimcha Amen LiYeshua UleNachama VeNaomar. Let the Holy One renew this month for us, the month of Nisan, for everyone who dwell on earth, for goodness, for peace, for joy, and happiness, and health. And let us say, and the month of Nisan begins on March 23rd, Thursday. So.
Mm-hmm. We'll return the Torah to the Ark at page 433.
Yehallelu Echem Adonai, Kinis Gov Shemo Levado, Hodo Aeretz Veshamahim, Vayahem Keren Leahamo, Tehila Lechol Chasidov, Livne Israel. Am kehovo, alleluia, alleluia.
Page 441. Shuva Adonai levevot al pei Yisrael, ki lakartuf natati lachem, torati al tazovu. Etz Chaim hi, lamachazikim bo, v'tomcheha mehushar, deracheha dochenom, v'chol netivoteha shalom. Ashivenu Adonai Elecha v'nashuvom Chadesh, Chadesh Yameinu Chadesh Yameinu Keker
So this is a moment when we have an opportunity to bless our children. I know we have several beautiful young people with us. So please, can we, and you can come up with your parents. How's that? When the children are blessed, parents are blessed. And so we turn to page 319. Please don't let, ma'am, we're gonna ask you to hold one corner of the talit. So we need one child to represent. To represent all the children. So it would be lovely. I'm not looking at anyone in particular. I'm just looking at my prayer book. So, anyone young at heart? There is more. You see, there's one shows up, another one show up. That's the nature of being in, right? Like a nachshon, right? The sea will open up, the sea of reeds will open up. Beautiful, right? To you, our beautiful children, our future, strength to your parents and our community. Yivarechecha Adonai v'yishmerecha. Ya'er Adonai panav alecha v'yichuneka. Yisa Adonai panav alecha v'yasem lecha shalom. May the Eternal bless you, protect you. May the Eternal face bring light to you. May the Eternal face be lifted towards you and bring you peace. And let us say, Amen. Amen. And we have treats, double. We have double. Today we have double. Thank you. It's not easy to choose just the right candy for you. Don't think it's easy.
Okay.
Please join me on page 445 for Aleinu.
Aleinu l'shabach la'adon hakol Latet gedula liyotzer bereshit Shenatan lanu v'rat emet V'chaye olam nata betocheinu Ve'anachnu korim U'mishtachavim u'modim Lifnei melech malchei ha'malchim HaKadosh כתוב בתורתך אדוני ימלוך לעולם ועד ונאמר והיה אדוני למלך כל הארץ ביום ההוא ביום ההוא יהיה אדוני אחד
Please be seated. Yes?
And this is a moment to remember. This is a moment to remember. But these are also moments to remember those who have came before us and blessed our life with meaning. Much of our experience of divine goodness, grace, and love has come to us through those whose lives have touched our own. Aria Gitterman, Michael Gitterman, and Gail Donner remember their mother, Anne Gitterman. Shirley Segev remembers her mother, Berta Sachs. Brahms Krever remembers his father, Bob Krever. Martin Davidson remembers his father, Charles Davidson. Jonathan Dostrovsky remembers his mother, Daphne Dostrovsky. Helen Davis remembers her brother, Maurice Gates. Harriet Liebman remembers her husband, Frank Liebman. Paul Fish remembers his mother, Gota Fish. Michael Rosenblatt remembers his mother, Hadassah Rosenberg.
Rana Kazansky remembers her father, Harry Kazansky. Louise Robinson remembers her father, Howard Cooper. Sid Zelovitz remembers his father, Isaac Zelovitz. Pauline Walsh remembers her father, Jack Manson. Arlene Krachmalnik remembers her mother, Lil Eisner. Sally Jacobs remembers her mother, Lily Jacobs. Gerald Silver remembers his father, Louis Silver. Judith Brooks remembers her mother, Margaret Kivavich. Elise Goldstein remembers her sister, Marsha Goldstein Quells. Henry Bulmash remembers his mother, Mary Bulmash. Gila Kopchik remembers her mother, Miriam Holtzman Nee Huberman. Myra Schiff remembers her brother, Richard Schiff. Susan Glickman remembers her mother, Rosalind Wolf Glickman. Morden Shapiro remembers his father, Roy Shapiro. Helen Davis remembers her father, Sandra Katz. Naomi Stein remembers her father, Sally Stein. Tone Klein remembers his mother, Annette Klein, and Hannah Solansky. Congregation, Darche Noam offers heartfelt condolences to our member, Nina Josefovitz, on the loss of her mother, Natasha Josefovitz, on Wednesday, March 15. The funeral was held Friday, March 17. It was held in California. The following families are in a period of Shloshim. Jeffrey and Rachel Picard are mourning the loss of their mother and mother-in-law, Susan Yagman. I just want to make sure that I read the names correctly. And Michael Rosenbluth remembers his mother, Hadassah Rosenbluth or Rosenberg? My apologies. Okay, it's written Hadassah Rosenberg, so. Those of you who observed Yortzeit and mourners, welcome to rise if you can. Those of you who are on Zoom, you're welcome to unmute and move a little bit away from the mic. And sometimes you mourn, but the names are not mentioned. Kaddish is yours. Kaddish Yatom is on page 451. Yitkadal v'yitkadash meh haba. Be'alma divra hirutei v'yamlich malchutei. B'chayichon v'yomichon v'chaye dekol beit Yisrael. Ba'agala uvizman kari v'imhu. Yehei shmeh haba mevorach le'olam almei almaya. Yitbarach v'yishtabach v'yitba'ar v'yithomam v'yitnaseh. Vit hadar vit ale vit alal shmede kudesha.
Brichu.
La ela min kol birchata veshirata, tush bechata venechamata, da miran bel mavim hu. Yehe shlama haba min shamaya, vechaim aleinu vial kol Yisrael vim hu. O se shalom bimumav, hu ya se shalom, aleinu vial kol Yisrael. May the one who creates harmony above make peace for us and for all Israel and for all who dwell on earth, and let us say. So, well, you know, joy is wedded to sorrow, so, you know, same coin, another side. So we continue, and it is L'chaim. There is a bit of an announcement. So can I ask Susan Bloom to come very quickly for quick announcement, and then we'll move towards closing song, V'shamru, and then thank you, Judy Howard, for hosting Zoom Kiddush. So please, Susan.
Thank you, Rabbi. I'll be quick. I know it's getting late. On this wonderful Shabbat morning of many celebrations, I want to add one more. We have an upcoming wonderful celebration on Sunday, June the 11th. You'll mark your calendars after Shabbat. Sunday, June the 11th, we are going to be celebrating the arts of our Darche Noam community. We have over 40, that's 40, members of our community in a wide variety of art forms who are going to be showing their talent and sharing it with us. In addition, we will be having visits and Q&As with the published authors. There's a room for the children to create their own art, so bring your children and grandchildren. Musical performances, always refreshments at Starchei Noam, and we're going to have a wonderful celebration getting together with our community. So stay tuned, more formal announcements will come out after Pesach, but I want to take this chance to add. Thanks.
For the last, for the closing song, I've chosen something that is very special to me. But actually, before I sing that, I want to just thank you so much for such an incredible outpouring of goodness, love, and support. I never would take that for granted, and it's really very important and special to me. I really appreciate it. And I always think this is such a two-way street, you know, you think I'm giving you, but in fact, I'm taking all the time. And that's really how it is. So I really thank you for that opportunity. It is an honor and privilege to dive in and sing with you and sometimes for you when the melodies get too complicated. But it's still a two-way street either way. So that's one thing. And the other one is about this closing song. I have chosen something that figures very strongly in so much of what we do, and that is a connection to our ancestors, as was so beautifully described with that metaphor, the mirror. We're looking into the mirror and see our ancestors, and I believe that as much has been said about the power of song and how special that is, I think songs, especially those based on the text of our ancestors, we feel them through it, and I think that's what makes them so special. And this particular song I will sing for you is one that has this incredible power in it, and it's actually been always said that it does have a power, and I, for one, really feel it in there. It's just the mystery of the past and how we all connect together is all in there. And that song, normally I only sing it on high holidays. It's called Anabekoach, and I hope that you will allow me to sing it a little bit out of context here, but as a special meaning to me, anyway.
Parushim kevot malchuto leholam havaed.
You have to be careful when you wear earrings with these masks. I keep getting caught. We're going to rise for Kiddush. We're on page 465, and I'm going to ask Mia and Lulu to help me. Okay, ready? Mia, ready?
Vishamru.
Vishamru v'nei Yisrael et ha-Shabbat la'asot et ha-Shabbat le'doratam berit olam v'nei u'v'nei Yisrael oti le'olam oti le'olam oti le'olam
Vishamru v'nei Yisrael et ha-Shabbat la'asot et ha-Shabbat le'doratam berit olam
v'niu v'minei Yisrael. I just did that, didn't I? Kisheshat yamim asa Adonai et ha-Shamayim
ve'et ha-Aretz
v'shamru
v'nei Yisrael et ha-Shabbat la'asot et ha-Shabbat le'doratam berit olam
u'vayom ha-shvi shavat v'inafash Shavat Faina Fash,
Shavat Faina Fash, Vishamru, Venei Israel, Et HaShabbat, Lasot Et HaShabbat, Ledoratam Berit Olam.
Al Kain Ber Hadonai Et Yom HaShabbat Katshehu, Savrei Chaverai.
Lachaim.
Baruch Ataronai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Borei Pri Hagafen.
Amen.
Take a sip, Mia. Take a sip. Okay. Oops. Okay. Girls, both of you.
Baruch Ataronai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Amatzi Lehem Min Haaretz.
Amen.
Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom.
It was in my freezer for 100 years.
Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom.